to get directly God himself as our child. If there is a possibility in our religion to invite God himself as our child, we can get divine children, pious children, virtuous children, children who are qualified, those who can show the way to the universe. So that we can get, that is the possibility of Garbhadhana. Garbhadhana is the samskara by which we are making the foundation. So foundation, pillar, mold, replication and settlement are the five purposes of samskara, they say. If the Garbhadhana is properly made, planting a mango seed and expecting coconut is very totally ridiculous and pizzatic. So Garbhadhana should be very proper. Garbhadhana, we consider it as an accident. We consider it as something emotional. We consider something as infatuational. We consider something as something biological and sensational. But that is a sacred act. Wherein by emotions of a person for unison is systematically channelized by means of a divine will, apart from his will to have a progeny, his forefathers' will to have a successful lineage, the will of his rishis to have a strong follower, the will of a god to have a supportive soldier for his mission. That type of thing is blended in that for a divine sankalpa. So our type of Garbhadhana is totally distinguishable from pigs getting piglets, cats getting kittens and dogs getting puppies. Therein by, we have certainly something different. For a divine order we are going to do that, but there is no such thing at all. First is sankalpa. A married couple, most of desire is entirely different from sankalpa. Desire is known as ichcha. A potential systematized desire is known as sankalpa. Mere desire having no potence, no rational, no applicability, no common sense is known as ichcha. Ichcha has no common sense. Ichcha has no rational. Ichcha has no contemporary understanding and utility understanding. Ichcha is pure. Double refined, pure agma, ichcha is desire. It has nothing at all. It does not see any of the practical long-term benefits or future benefits or all-round benefits. Sankalpa is a designed, a directed, a well-programmed desire which is potentialized by a divine command through shastras and through abhyasas. So we are having sankalpa, number one. Number two, we are having vrata. First of all, both the couple, they should take some sankalpa. That is lokodharaka, kulodharaka, putram yekam kankhe. You have to say that we want a child who can uplift our clan as well as the society. So this is sankalpa, to take a strong desire. Second is the vrata. Sankalpa is different from vrata, I have already told. Taking the sankalpa, strong determination on a day is, I have already told. Vrata is till you get that, you have to follow that. So if sankalpa is a determination, a dedicated follow-up till you get the benefit is known as vrata. And third thing is kala. What is kala? According to shastras, there is a chart of divinity. You know that Kashyapa Prajapati had two wives, Diti and Aditi, and devas and asuras are having the same father, born to different mothers due to this time mismanagement. Even though Kashyapa was a divine personality, has a divine productive seed to create a celestially qualified person, he created demonic structures because of time mismanagement. So a person's inherent productivity along with the compatibility of time that gives you best breed. So Kashyapa's example to produce the daityas or the demons are best example for that. So time is also entirely essential. Shodhana is the fourth exercise. What is Shodhana? There are a lot of things which the modern people, they don't believe. When the Garbhadhana should be done from the menstrual discharge, what is the date? And fourth day, fifth day, sixth day, seventh day, each and every day they have mentioned. One is Garbhanasha, second is Ayurnasha, third thing is Putranasha, and one thing is Durbuddhi or Durmedha. So innumerable such things are given in Shastras. Somebody, we cannot teach them now, but somebody should, at least we should sit together and publish it in net so that people can access it. The Shastras, especially the Bodhayana, Ashwalayana, these people, they have made the Shrauta Sutras, Griha Sutras, and there are innumerable treatises known as Garbhadhana Rahasya, Garbhadhana Chandrika, Veera Mitrodaya, Samskara Chandrika, Samskara Mayuka, Samskara Ratrakara. Innumerable treatises are there where we can get lot of information about these charts. So there is a Shodhana. We have to check about the physical compatibility, the mental compatibility, the menstrual compatibility of that particular female to adapt a potential thing. Not to get any progeny, but to get a potential progeny. That's what I told on a fertility lecture I delivered. I told about fertility, that a fertile fertilization is known as fertility. Real fertilization, that eggs maturity and getting a child, it is not fertility. Getting a fertile child, fertile in everything, an enriched child with all status, in all moods, that is known as fertility. So that is known as shodhana. The last thing is known as palana. Even after the conception, till the delivery, till the labor and delivery occurs, that should be cared with spiritual nourishment. That should be guarded by a spiritual armor, so that evil forces will not go inside and the spiritual nourishment will not ooze out or leak out or be debilitated or dilapidated, or it should be prevented from any other attack from the external forces. So we have first sankalpa, second is vrata, that is very much essential. Sankalpa and vrata, nobody is now doing. Third is kala, fourth is shodhana, and the fifth thing is palana. This thing is very much essential. And the second thing is, second samskara, which is there meant in the shastras, is pumsavana. To get a puman. Puman prasuyate yena karmana, tat karma pumsavanam. This is the definition given. We want a male child. God has given two tools for development of spiritual lineage. One is sahayoga. Second is prayoga. Somebody who is doing the spiritual rite. Second is somebody who is assisting, associating and materializing the spiritual rite. So God has created females for materializing the spiritual deeds, that is known as sahayoga. For performance of spiritual deeds, He has created the male kingdom as per the shastras. So prayoga is known as puman and sahayoga is known as three. They are meant for the same purpose. It is in the form of the bullock cart in which two bullocks, they travel for the same distance. So even shastra say that ayagnyo yeshahi apatrika. If a person is not a patrika, not having a wife, he is ayagnya, he is unqualified for doing any ritual. So that is, unless he is a brahmachari or sannyasi, each and everybody, a qualified person is only a sapatrika, one who is with wife. And even in the Vedas, we are having a lot of rishikas, women rishis. And there was a question in one vicharasadas, how so many rishis, they are doing rituals, and somebody it is told that they are doing that Upanayana also, those people there also, rishikas for Vedic mantras like Gargi, Maitreyi, and the shastras, they give samadhana that rajovihinaha, yetaha rajovihinaha. Those type of specially qualified people, out of their tapasya, they have crossed the menstrual cycle. So the divide of this menstrual discharge, by means of which they are having a superhuman physical structure by which they are not comparable to women of modern standards. So that is pumsavana. First, immediately the first child should be for God, for divine service, for runamochana, for releasing the debt of Deva, Pitru, Rishis. We are having six runas, Deva, Pitru and Rishi, that is spiritual. And in our family, generally we are having for three people. That is Sikshaka, second is Pita, third thing is Rashtra Pita or Neta. We are having three runas. One runa is for the Neta, the king. Second is for our Pita, for our own father. Third is Sikshaka, for our instructor or teacher. By getting good education, by getting complete education and proper occupation, Sikshaka runa is satisfied. The Pita is propitiated when we earn money and take care of him. The Neta is propitiated when we contribute something for the national development. So that thing is subtle triad, and it is known as a tangible triad, and each and everybody is born indebted to these two pairs of triads. So these things are there in our spiritual things. So we have to start with that pumsavana to get. Puman means, it also gives one more meaning. Any person with courage, and any person, see, there are two qualities. Whenever even a person, a masculine person, whenever a male, he observes something known as Shantarasa or Karunarasa, he becomes molten wax. Before an Acharya, before Devasanidhana, before elders, even a person who is male and who is a very big bodybuilder or maybe a wrestler, a good warrior, he observes very much humble nature, and he observes very much politeness, he observes subservience and submission. So quality, they differ on circumstances. Even